Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name's Murray. If this is your first time here, I am a singer-songwriter from Texas. And usually on this channel, I'm putting out cover songs or originals, just depending on the day. But today I want to put out something a little bit different. So one of the things I love as a songwriter myself is I love to find and watch other YouTube videos on songwriters and documentaries and things. And I came across a documentary the other day, and I'm going to link that documentary below because I want to give them full credit for this. But at the very end of this documentary, there's a clip, and it is one of the most powerful things I've gotten to watch as far as the story behind a song. And so if you've ever heard Lee Brice's song, I Drive My Truck, or I Drive Your Truck, it went to number one on the charts. The story behind that song is unbelievable. So I came across that. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to fade this clip in and let you guys watch the story behind I Drive Your Truck. I hope you guys enjoy this. Again, in the description, I will link the full documentary. I recommend you go watch it. The whole documentary is amazing, but this clip especially is something special. Enjoy.
I mean, it's just one of those weird things where you never know in my world what day is gonna be a day that's gonna change your life or change other people's lives, you know. I show up at this building pretty much every day and I sit in a room this big. And that particular day, I remember not even really wanting to go to work, which is unlike me, but I thought, you know, Connie Harrington, I saw her on my calendar and I thought, you know, worst case scenario, we'll go have lunch, it'll be fine. So Connie had just pieces of paper and post-it notes, and she's always shuffling through all these ideas. She came to this one and she started to cry. And I was like, what's that?
I was driving home and I listened to talk radio, NPR radio, regularly. And then this man comes on. He was trying to petition to get the right to put flags on the graves of not just his son's grave, whom he lost in Afghanistan, but all the soldiers in that particular cemetery. And they asked him, how did he cope with losing his son? And he said, I drive his truck. And he said, it burns, you know, gas like crazy. We drive it anyway, you know, because he felt closest to him.
She literally was crying so hard that she could not even tell me the title. She would get the story started and then break down.
And I'm driving, you know, and I keep little yellow post-it notes, and I'm writing down the details of this truck and sticking them on my dash, trying not to wreck. And so I thought, that deserves to be written about.
I mean, we've literally just cried our way through about 4 hours of just imagery, writing words on a page. I felt so strong that I had to treat this idea with kid gloves because I knew that there hadn't been a lot of songs written about grief.
But we both agreed at the end of the day, it would be good to get a guy's perspective on it, you know? So we debated who that should be and arrived at Jimmy Erie.
There's, you know, 8 male songwriters just in this building we could have called. And if we had called any of the other ones, it wouldn't be I Drive Your Truck that we have today. And so we booked another writing appointment and he came in and me and him got the guitars out. He had kind of a melody going. It was perfect.
When I write, when I get so far and I realize today's going well enough, this is gonna be a real song, I will type in the date and I will type in the title. And when I did that, I just stopped, burst into tears, and they were like, what's wrong? I'm like, we wrote that song on June 21st. When I zoomed in on the picture of Jared C. Monty's grave, he was killed June 21st.
The second she said it, I got a chill at my body because I knew this is important. We've got to get this in the right hands and the right artist. And Lee Brice took it all the way to number one, which was unbelievable. All along, though, we're fantasizing, thinking, has that dad heard it? This guy that said it on the interview, is it possible that he's a country music fan that he would hear this song?
Last time I talked to my son, the phone rang. Hi, Pop, how you doing? Happy Father's Day. And he was on a satellite phone in Afghanistan talking to me. And we talked for a while, and then he said, Pop, I gotta go. We're going on a mission. That was on June 18th, 2006. And he left for the mission, and 3 days later, I had men walking up my driveway to tell me he had been killed. Yeah, that's the Medal of Honor.
How did it make you feel when you heard that song for the first time?
Sad, tearful. It was very difficult to listen to. I mean, I think I only got partway through the song. I had to shut it off. And it's still pretty much that way. I still don't get to get all the way through.
Have your other kids heard the song?
Oh, yeah. Both my daughter and my son are so hurt by their brother's death that they've reacted and...
Truck. where you left it. Yeah, man, I crank it up. You probably punch my arm right now if you could see this tear rolling down my face. Well, man, I'm trying to be tough. Yeah, mama asked me this morning if I'd been by your grave. But that flag and stone ain't where I feel you anyway. I drive your truck, roll every window down, and I burn up every back road in this town. I find a field, I tear it up till all the pain's a cloud of dust. Yeah, sometimes I drive your truck. Ooh. Well, I've cussed, I've prayed, I've said goodbye. I've shook my fist, asked God why. These days when I'm missing you this much, I know you miss me. I drive your truck, roll every window down, burn up every back road in this town, find a field, tear it up till all the pain's a cloud of dust. Sometimes, Jared, sometimes I drive you.
Awesome.